Hi, everybody. Today we're going to talk about the Sadi, which is a really beautiful letter. It's very graceful. And I love it because it's so pretty and it's fun to draw. If you're interested in drawing the Sadi, which I will hold up so you can copy, actually, by just pausing the screen, and you can pause the screen now and go get your crayons and paper or paper and pencil and paper, and I'll hold one up so you can copy it. One of the better ones. Okay. So here are some of the Sadis. This is, I was really into angels. I still am into angels, but anyway, in the beginning when I drew these letters. So there is the, these are my beginning letters, so they might, I changed them after a while, but this this is the Nun, and this is the Yud. It's composed of a Nun and a Yud. Oh, that's my, I'm not going to tell you that yet. And here's another one with the angel. These were painted in 1997. Couple years after I started painting. And this is the final Sadi. See how graceful the top is? So this is, I should go back and say that the Sadi is one of five letters that have two forms. One is the form in the beginning of the letter and the middle, and then the other form is at the end. It's called Sadi Tzofit. Like Kaf Sofit, or Nun Sofit, or Mem Sofit, and Pei Sofit, and it means, Sofit means end. So this is the end letter. And so the five letters that have that beautiful second letter, or second form. And here's how I came to draw it, because the Nun actually has a Yud at the top of it. So that's how I draw my Sadis. And here's the Yud over here, but this is the Yud that goes with the Nun. And here's another one. I like those much better than the first ones. And this is, it means, the Sadi has a wonderful, wonderful name. It means righteousness. And so here is my idea with the rabbi and the Torah. It's the best I could do with righteousness. Some of them are much more clear. And so the Sadi is also one of the Shat Nazgat's letters. Those are the letters that can be, have a little crown on the top. There's a wonderful story in Menachot and Talmud that talks about Moses going to heaven and watching God. I just love this story. Watching God affix these tagin, which are actually three little Zions together, like a crown. So here I did a painting recently of the three. So you can see that this is the Sadi that you learned about a few weeks ago. And three of them together sort of make a little crown, and they go on the tops of the letters. But I love that story about Moses seeing God. It's so sweet. So we are going to, and I don't know if I mentioned that these are called tagin. The little crowns. I love all these stories. I love all these stories. So we're going to do, so hopefully you've drawn your own version of the Sadi. Did I say I'd hold one up for a while? I'll hold this one up. And then, whoops, I can't see. Oh dear, it needs to be further out. Okay. And then you could trace it. Anyway, you can just pause it. I don't need to hold it up here forever. And you can draw it. Anyway, if you have done that, Then we're going to do a short meditation on the Tsadi, which is a letter that so many people are attracted to, because, including myself, because it has a wonderful meaning, and because it's so beautiful. It's just a beautiful, beautiful letter, kind of like the Lamed in its gracefulness. So, anyway, I'm going to think about my Tsadi. And my Tsadi is red. It has a really bright red border, and then it's a paler red, but it's still red on the inside. And it's jumping around, which that has never happened before. Anyway, I'm going to try and subdue it here, because there are three ways that I sit in the Tsadi. One, I can climb up and sit with my head nestled under that nun and my feet out and just rocking it like I do in so many letters. Or I can sit with my, like it's a motorcycle, with the nun behind me and the yod ahead so I can steer. And then I can sit in the curve, the bottom curve, and the Tsadi will rock me. Today I'm going to sit the top one with the head of the nun nestled over my head. It's a very comfortable letter. So we're going to take just a minute or so and sit with this letter quietly. So now it's time to come back to your room, wherever you're sitting. And if you ever want to do this with me one-on-one, I have many clients that like to do that. Working with my website is called Jewish Meditation and Practical Spirituality. So we work on all kinds of things using the letters and writings from Talmud. If you want a fuller explanation of this letter, you can go to my Facebook page, and it'll have I'll put the Tsadi up all week, and you will be able to see more stories about the Tsadi than I was able to talk about today. And also, I have a new website. I had a website, HebrewLetters.com, and I closed it about 6 years ago, and now I'm opening a new website, and you'll be able to buy purses and all kinds of pillows and canvas prints and all that kind of stuff if you're interested. So that's called Hebrew Letters. Better to use it without the www. It works better. And you have to type it in. So anyway, that's what it is, HebrewLetters.com, and that link will be below. So I thank you so much for joining me today and being with me while we work our way through these wonderful mystical paths of wonder. Thanks for being here. Bye. I see you next week.